Welcome to Hoops High, Chicago's leader in youth-produced sports broadcasting and youth media education. Hoops High is produced by high school students learning the skills of professional broadcasting. Hoops High is the flagship program of Free Spirit Media and is made possible in partnership with After School Matters, the Chicago Public Schools, and Chicago Access Network Television. We hope you enjoy the show.
Hi, my name is Desha, and we are here at the Collins campus where North Lawndale take on Mutian. Stay tuned for more Hoops High.
Hi, I'm Shiora Hart.
And I'm Latrell Hassel.
And you're watching Hoops High.
Yeah, Hoops Jackson, I see. Yeah, this is Hoops High. Yeah, Precious Anderson, I see. This is Hoops High. Okay, this is Hoops High. Hoops High is the name, ruler of the game. The crowd goes insane. The fouls are replayed. No time is delayed. Heat up the flame. The camera so focused it'll burn you with the aim. I'm Mr. Swag back late, chilling in the shade with the boss Sean Cave. They plug the weed at the seats in the range. Flow a half court shot, raindrop. Let it steal with you long range. Watch them dunk the ball down. Turn the channel 19 now. Yes, we run this town like the track team fam. What's away your slip when you walk in? We on the sideline, changes close and recording a game. It's our own. Press stun in my headphones, can hear her talking. Latrell on the announcements, just see him call it. The team is Walgreens and the score is the talk. This is HoopsHIGH reporting live from the Swag Guy. Nicholas Jackson, I see. Precious Henderson, I see.
I'm Nicole Strickler.
And I'm Dantrell Gibson.
And welcome to Hoops High. Today we are here at the Collins Academy campus for the North Lawndale versus Team Englewood game. It should be very exciting. It is also senior night for North Lawndale Phoenix. So we're representing our seniors out here for this to be their last season playing with their high school. It should be very exciting, so make sure you stay tuned. Right now we're going to get into our Englewood.
All right, your starting lineup. You have Charton Moorman. You have Johnny Rowland. You have number 24, Malik Johnson. Number 25, Jamie Finley. Also,
and those are your starting lineup for Team Englewood. And we are about to start you off with the starting lineup for the North Lawndale Phoenix.
Number four, you have D'Angelo Thigpen. And guard, you have Corey McCrary. One of North Lawndale's top scorers. You have DeAndre Holden. Senior. You have Jacquez Jones. Damn. You have Brandon D. Thorpe. That's your North Lawndale's starting lineup.
We are about to get into the game, ladies and gentlemen. Are you excited, Detrell?
Very excited. I want to see what the outcome of this game is going to be.
Yeah, me too, because I've never seen Englewood play before.
Me neither, but I know we have someone, Jamie Finley, he used to go to North Lawndale.
Yeah, he transferred his sophomore year over into Team Englewood. Also, the Lawndale's football team lost to go into the championship, lost their championship game to Team Englewood with football, actually. So let's see how this basketball
game. See if they're gonna get revenge on the basketball court.
Yes, yes, yes. Should be very, very interesting. The crowd is hype. We have a big crowd out here today.
Yeah, very big crowd. I think it's mainly due to senior night. In the center, you had the two big men. For Englewood, you have Charton Moore, and you have another big man, DeAndre Holden.
Right now.
As North Lawndale get possession of the tip off. Ball pass Jaquez Jones to Corey McCrary. And it's a loose ball. Picked up. And it was an air ball. D'Angelo Thigpen with the ball. He goes all the way for the layup and it's no good. Rebounded by Brandon Thorpe. Jaquez Jones goes for the three and it's no good. Rebounded by number 25, Jamie Finley. As Jamie Finley passed to number 13, Johnny Rowland. Rowland with the ball. As he dribbled, rolling guarded by D'Angelo Thigpen. He slings the ball to number 23. McLaurin with the ball. Pass to Jamie Finley. Finley feeds it to number 3. Moore for the shot, and it's no good. Rebounded by Corey McCrary, but a pushing foul was called. And Englewood will keep possession of the ball. As number 13, Johnny Rowland inbounds the ball.
And it's out of bounds.
And it's going to be a turnover. North Lawndale's ball.
They have Corey McCrary inbound the ball for North Lawndale Phoenix.
Jaquez Jones with the ball. He slings D'Angelo Thigpen. And Jaquez Jones inbounds the ball to D'Angelo Thigpen. Thigpen feeds it to Jones. Jones with the fake. See, he gets ripped up. Number 13 with the ball. Feeds it to number 23. He passes. And a foul is called. And it seemed like number 32, D'Angelo Walkermore, will go to the line and shoot two.
I think he was fouled by Brandon Thorpe from North Lawndale Phoenix.
Okay. Rocky Moore at the line as he goes up for his first free throw attempt. And it is
good
to put the first basket on the board.
Rocky Moore for his second free throw attempt. And it is good.
Thigpen with the ball. He passed to McCrary. McCrary guarded by Finley. Passed to Thick. Jaquez Jones for three. And it's no good. Rebounded by Corey McCrary. And no good. Grabbed by Holden. Holden put the ball where it needs to be. Jamie Finley inbounds the ball. Rolling with the ball. As he dribbles, rolling guarded by Thorpe. This is a double team. Ball pass to Finley. Number 23 goes for the shot.
And it's good.
Good. Montrell McLaurin. McCrary with the ball. Jock for another three. And he doesn't answer his back. Rebounded by Finley. Finley dribbles the ball. Finley looking for the open man. Guarded by Brandon Thor, but a turnover was. And it was an offensive foul. So North Lawndale would get possession of the ball. Corey McCrary would take the ball out. Craven inbounds to Thigpen. Thigpen guarded by McLaurin. He passed to McQuarrie. Looking for the old man Thorpe with the ball. He passes it to Jock. Jock blows by, feeds it to Holden, to the big guy, and Holden gets fouled. He's going to the line to shoot two.
And right now we have DeAndre Holden at the line, and he's going to go up for his first free throw attempt. And it is no good.
DeAndre Holden goes up for a second free throw attempt.
And that's no good.
Rebounded by number 32, Rockamore. McLaurin passed the ball to Finley. Finley with the ball. He feeds it. It's stolen by Jacquez Jones. He feeds it to McQuarrie. McQuarrie for the layup, and it's good. And the crowd goes wild. Finley takes the ball out. Ball inbounded to McLaurin. McLaurin passed the ball to number 32. And Englewood will keep possession of the ball. Ball went out on D'Angelo Thigpen as he dabbed on the floor. Jamie Finley will take the ball out. Ball inbounded to McLaurin. Brandon Thorpe playing good defense.
They're going to have number 25, Jamie Finley, inbound the ball.
McLaurin with the ball. Jamie Finley picks up the loose ball. Jamie Finley double team. North Lawndale playing very aggressive defense as they dive on the floor, and it's a jump ball. Thigpen hustling.
And just in case you didn't know, the teams that are currently playing are Team Englewood versus the North Lawndale Phoenix. The school colors for North Lawndale would be black and white, and the school colors for Team Englewood would be purple and black.
As Jamie Finley takes the ball out. Ball inbound to Roland. Roland with the ball. Roland dribbles, guarded by Thigpen. He looking for the open man. A pick was set. Roland goes. He passed to the big guy. And a 3-second violation was called. As Corey McCrary will take the ball out. The ball inbounded to D'Angelo Thigpen. Thigpen dribbles the ball. Pass to McCrary. Jacquez Jones with the ball. He feeds to McQuarrie. McQuarrie for three, and it's good. Sorry, that was a 2-point basket.
Yeah. But that would now put our score at 7-5. We have 4 minutes and 42 seconds left in our first quarter in North Lawndale. It has the lead by 2 points.
And there was a turnover. It's Corey McQuarrie will.
Inbound the ball.
Ball inbound to Jacquez Jones. He passes to DeAndre Holden. Holden fakes.
And
looking for the foul. Thigpen with the ball. Thigpen guarded by Roland. He passed Jacquez Jones. Jones for three, and it's good. Third attempt, and it's good.
Third time's a charm.
Oh, well. Jones with the steal, and he goes all the way. Oh,
air ball.
Nearly missed. Roland with the ball. Roland looking for the open man, as he's double teamed. Johnny passed the ball, and it's stolen by Jacquez Jones once again. He looking to set up a play. Looking for the old man. He feeds it to Thigpen. Ooh!
That was a crossover.
Wow. Thigpen, what a move. Rolling with the ball.
It's stolen by Brandon Thorpe.
Pass to Jacquez Jones. And it's stolen by Roland.
Wow, but right now, we have a timeout on the court, so we're going to take you to a quick commercial break. You are watching Hoops High.
You get all thing out there.
We,
I did my thing out there.
Ain't no Iron Team.
It's the Iron Championship, though.
I can't believe you.
You believe in this championship, though? Real player.
Hey, man, y'all, get off my homeboy.
Yeah. Better be glad he hold me back. Hey, but we still cool, though, you know?
Hi, this is Scottie Pippen, and you're watching Hoops High.
Back to the game, ladies and gentlemen.
Welcome back. You are watching Hoops High. Right now, we are in the middle of our first quarter. We have 3 minutes and 37 seconds left. The score right now is 10-5, and North Lawndale is up. It's been quite interesting. I must say, been fast-paced, a lot of good blocks, great defense from North Lawndale Phoenix as well.
And Finley inbounds the ball to Roland. Roland guarded by Garrett Taylor. He's rolling dribbles. He passes the ball, and it was picked up by number 3, Moore. Rolling with the ball. Rolling looking for the open man. He passed to Finley. Finley for 3, and it's
no good.
Rebound by McQuarrie. McQuarrie pushes the ball. Seems like he's going to go all the way, and it was
locked.
It's not happening in this town.
But he's going to inbound the ball, Corey McQuarrie, for the North Lawndale Phoenix.
And subs are made. Thigpen goes to the bench, and then it's Jones. Sorry. McQuarrie goes to the bench, and then it's Jones. Jones inbounds the ball to Taylor. Back to Jones. Drops feeds the ball to Taylor. It's Thigpen. Thigpen guarded by Roland. As he dribbles, he passes GT. Thigpen with the ball. Looking to set up a play. Garrett Taylor passes the ball to Jacquez Jones. Jones sees the fakes. He passes. Shot put up by Garrett Taylor, and it's good. Finley inbounds the ball to Moore. Moore guarded by Jones. Finley passes the ball to Roland. Roland dribbles. Roland guarded by Thigpen. Thigpen looking for the help. Thigpen sticking good defense as the ball was passed and the shot was made
by number 23.
Number 23, Montrell McLaurin.
And this will be his second 3 in our first quarter as well.
Thigpen passes Garrett. Back to Thigpen. Back to Garrett. Looking to set up a play. Thigpen passes Jacquez Jones. Jacquez Jones feeds the ball to Holden, the big guy. Holden passes the ball to Thorpe. Thorpe for the shot.
It's air ball, no good.
Thorpe looking to draw a foul, and it's no good.
You are watching Hoops High. Remember, you can watch Hoops High every Saturday at 8 p.m. on CAN-TV. Channel 19 for all the hottest sports high school action around.
Moore with the ball. Moore, Jacquez with another steal, third steal. Jacquez guarded by Finley. He feeds the ball to Thigpen, to Garrett. Garrett for 3, and it's good. What a shot made by Garrett.
Garrett also known to be a pretty good three-point shooter for the North Lawndale Phoenix. He's been playing all 4 years.
Yes. Johnny Rowland with the ball. Rowland feeds the ball to Moore. Moore passes to Finley. Finley, and it gets blocked by Holden. And the foul, pushing foul was called on D'Angelo Thigpen. As number 1 gets into the bench, Wendell.
And he's also a key player for the Englewood Eagles. And
Jamie Finley inbounds the ball. The ball inbounded, and it's thrown somewhere else. And it's a turnover, North Lawndale's ball.
I just see the replay on the screen. And they're going to have number 24, Jacquez Jones, inbound the ball to D'Angelo Thigpen.
Thigpen with the ball. Thigpen guarded by number 24, Johnson. Jacquez Jones with the ball. As he goes, and a trap, and a doubling violation was called, and it will be a turnover. Englewood's ball. Johnny Rowland looking to inbound the ball. He inbounds the ball to Wendell. Wendell with the ball. Wendell guarded. And it goes out of bounds. Number 24, Malik Johnson. As Brandon Thorpe would take the ball out. Ball inbound to Thigpen. Thigpen guarded by Malik Johnson. As he feeds the ball to Jacquez Jones, but a traveling violation was called. Ball inbound to Wendell. Wendell passes the ball.
Holding gets the ball. Steal.
Brandon gets the ball. Brandon looking to make a play. He goes all the way and gets the foul, and he's going to the line to shoot three, guys.
Brandon Thorpe with good handles on that play. And this will be his first time at the line. Also, Hoops High is produced by high school students learning to be professional broadcasters. All of the camera work, announcing, directing, and everything else is done by young students.
As he misses his first free throw attempt. And subs are made on Englewood bench. Brandon Thorpe goes up for another shot, and it's no good. Rebounded, but stolen by Garrett Taylor, and put back was incomplete. And a foul was called on Brandon Thorpe, and he doesn't agree with it.
Not at all, but just in case you didn't know, the score right now is 15-8, and North Lawndale is still up.
Johnny Rowland with the ball. Johnny Rowland inbounds the ball to number 22, Owens. Rowland passes the ball to number 24, Malik Johnson, and the ball goes out of bounds. It's a turnover, North Lawndale's ball.
We got 23.3 seconds left, but not third. North Lawndale right now is coming up on top. They have pretty good defense. Their offense has been well, too. They've been playing really well as a team tonight.
Brandon Thorpe with the ball. He feeds it back to Thigpen. Garrett Taylor feeds the Thigpen to Brandon Thorpe. It seems like they're going to play the passing game and waste our time. 6 seconds left on the board. Thigpen passes to Garrett Taylor. Garrett Taylor passes to Thigpen. Thigpen for the shot, and it's no good. That would be the, that would conclude the first quarter, ladies and gentlemen.
Yes, yes. And we conclude the first quarter with the score. It's still 15-8. And right now we're going to hand it over to our sideline reporter, Daisha Henderson.
Hi, my name is Daisha, and I'm here with Kendall Strickland. So, Kendall, seeing that you are a North Lawndale student, how do you think North Lawndale is playing today?
They've been playing great so far, but, you know, they're trying to play an up-tempo game, trying to get it over with fast.
So what do you think that they need to do to improve to keep the lead?
Step up on defense. Look like they slacking.
Thank you. Now we're going to toss it back to the announcers.
Thank you much, Daisha. And welcome back, everybody. We are about to kick off our second quarter. Netcha, what do you expect?
Well, it seems like North Lawndale are playing very aggressive and playing good defense, though I think they should slow down on their aggressiveness to keep them going in the penalty with the fouls. But I can't complain. North Lawndale, they're really playing their hearts out. And Englewood, they're also playing a good game, knocking up some big threes and big shots when they really need it.
Yeah.
But the game is still close, and it's still possible for Englewood to come back.
Of course. We still have a lot of time left.
Ball inbounded to VT. Devontae Johnson with the ball. Feeds to Malcolm. Malcolm passes the ball to number one, Smith. Back to Malcolm. And with the freshman, number 21, Kevin Grace. Kevin Grayson goes to the line to shoot free throws.
Elizabeth!
Grayson goes up for his first free throw attempt. And it is.
No good.
Stolen by Malcolm. Malcolm passes it. And it gets blocked. Wow.
And Antoine Smith got his shot by number three.
Moore passes the ball to Wendell.
Moore.
And a foul was called. As number 13, Johnny Rowland will take the ball out. Ball inbounded to number 24, Malik Johnson. Malik Johnson goes for the shot and it's no good. But they will keep possession of the ball.
Again, ladies and gentlemen, this is senior night for the North Lawndale Phoenix.
The ball inbounded to Owens. Wendell with the ball. He passes number 13, Rowland. Freeman, air ball. And the layup, easy layup, was made by Jalen Smith. Ball passed to number 22, Owen. And the shot was called off by a traveling violation. Enough run there with the possession of the ball.
Malcolm Boyd will inbound the ball for North Lawndale Phoenix.
Devontae Johnson with the ball. Pass back to Malcolm. Back to Devontae. Johnson with the ball. He sees the opening. He goes to Grayson. Grayson gets his block. And it's a turnover. Englewood with possession of the ball. Johnny Rowland passes the ball. Rowland gets the ball back. Pass to number 15. Rushing. And a foul was called. Coach Thornton not happy with the call. Number 11 with the ball. Sorry. Rolling with the ball. He passes to number 15. And it's stolen by Grayson. Grayson feeds the ball to Devontae. Devontae passes the ball to Smith. Smith feeds it to number 33.
And there'll be a foul call.
Antoine Smith going to the line.
For two shots. We have 6 minutes and 11 seconds left in our second quarter. Score right now is 18-8. North Lawndale up by 10. As Smith gets ready for his first free throw attempt. And it is good. Antoine Smith again for his second free throw attempt.
And that was no good. And it's stolen but blocked. Jamie Finley with the ball as he passes it to Rowland. Rowland dribbles. Rowland feeds the ball to Finley. Finley, number 15, rushing. As number one, Wendell draws the foul and he's going to the line.
Foul number 10, Devontae Johnson, that's his first.
Wendell, 6'1", weighing 185 pounds, a senior. Will attend the college, Central State University.
Yes.
As he goes off for his first free throw attempt.
And it is good.
It's good.
Into the ball game. For North Lawndale, number
32. Wendell will go off for his second free throw attempt.
And that one is no good.
Rebounded by Smith. Johnson with the ball. He feeds it. Grayson puts him in a basket. And the timeout was called by Englewood.
And we are going to take it to a quick commercial break. You're watching Hoops High.
What is this? That's what I'm talking about. Thank you.
good luck.
Come back next time, I guess.
Got you, man.
You didn't earn this.
This is Lawndale, you're watching Hoops High.
Back, ladies and gentlemen, to Hoops High. We are here at Collins Academy campus for the North Lawndale versus Team Englewood game. We have 5 minutes and 43 seconds left in our second quarter. The score right now is 21-9. North Lawndale is up.
Yeah, what a game. I think Englewood really need to step up on offense and make better shot selections in order to keep the lead mm-hmm. from being such a big gap, but overall, it seems like they're showing a little bit more hustle. I think the starters need to get a little bit more time to put some points on the board.
I agree. Well, let's get right back into this game as Jamie Finley will inbound the ball.
Ball inbounded to Wendell. Back to Jamie Finley. Rolling with the ball. Rolling with the double team. Wendell with the ball. And it's kicked and picked up by Grayson. Johnson dribbles the ball. He goes for the pass. And the three-point was missed. Number four with the ball. And the ball was rebounded and put back. Missed. And it will go off the body of number 21, Kelvin Grayson. Rolling with the ball. Rolling past the Russian. Back to Rolling. It's number 15 gets the ball. And the basket. Finally, a basket is made by Jamie Finley. Johnson with the ball. And it goes out of bounds. Off of number 40, Jefferson. He's Jefferson.
Well, that would be Bynum. Keith Bynum. He's also on the Frost-Off team. For North Lawndale Phoenix, he's wearing number 40. Jamie Finley with inbound the ball for Team Englewood.
As number 13, Johnny Rowland has possession of the ball. Rolling with the ball, rolling double team. And he feeds the ball to Finley. Finley for a shot, and it's no good. Rebounded. Got a big guy. Johnson with the ball. Johnson goes all the way, and it's good. He put the ball where it needs to be. As Jamie Finley inbounds the ball. Ball inbounded, but stolen. As the layup was missed, Grayson will go to the line to shoot two as he was fouled.
Yes, also a shout out to the North Lawndale cheerleaders. They're over there getting their groove on. But right now, Grayson is going to get ready for his first free throw attempt.
As Grayson goes up for his first free throw attempt. And it is.
No good.
As number 5, Tyrone McKenzie gets into the game. To the bench is number 1, Wendell.
With the replay on the screen, ladies and gentlemen, with the layup.
Grayson makes the second free throw attempt. Splits him. McKenzie with the ball. McKenzie double team pass to number 13, Rowland. Rowland, double team. As Johnny Rowland takes the ball out.
And there are some substitutions made. Well, the whole team is being substituted for the North Lawndale Phoenix. Right now we have in D'Angelo Thigpen, Jaquez Jones, Brandon Thorpe. Well, yeah, in the starting lineup, you're right.
Rowland with the ball. He goes all the way, and it's good. Thick holding, inbounds the ball. Thigpen with the ball. Thigpen passes to McQuarrie, back to Jones, and Jones for the three, and it's good. That boy is on fire. Rolling with the ball. Rolling looking to shake up his man. Rolling passes it to number 3, and it's picked up by Jaquez Jones. Pass to Thigpen. Thick Pen dribbles the ball. Thick Pen, double team. See pass to McCrary. McCrary for a three, and it's no good. Rebounded by Jamie Finley. Finley with the ball. See dribbles up court. Finley looking to set up a play. Finley guarded by Jacquez Jones. Rolling with the ball. As he dribbles. Rolling guarded by McCrary as he passes the ball to McKenzie. McKenzie for a three. And it's air ball.
Also, Hoops High is the flagship program of Free Spirit Media and is running partnership with After School Matters, the Chicago Public Schools, and CAN TV. It's a team effort all around, and we are grateful for our partners who make this possible.
Thick Pen with the ball. He's passing McCrary. Thick Pen passes Jones. Jones to Holden. Holden goes all the way, and he gets the foul, but not the bucket, as he will go to the line to shoot two. Holding the first free throw attempt, and it is good. Holding goes up for a second one, and it is good as well. Jamie Finley takes the ball out. Ball inbounded to Rowland. Rowland guarded by Thick Pen as he dribbles. He goes all the way, and it's no good. Rebounded and put back in by number 15, Ray Rushing. Brandon Thorpe with the ball. Pass to Thick Pen. Thick Pen back to Thorpe. Thorpe to McCrary. McCrary double team. He passes to Thick Pen. Thick Pen. What the? He gets the traveling violation.
Yes, he does. And right now we have 2 minutes and 28 seconds left in our first half. The score is 29-15, and North Lawndale still maintains the lead. And they're going to have Jamie Finley inbound the ball.
Rolling with the ball. Rolling, and it's knocked out of bounds. Englewood will keep possession of the ball. And subs are made on both ends of the bench. McCrary goes to the bench as long as Tyrone McKenzie. Ray Rushing with the ball. And a traveling violation was called. Johnson inbounds the ball to Thick Pen. Thick Pen to Taylor. Taylor to Jones. Jones for the open three, and it's no good. Rebounded by Johnson. And Jacquez Jones makes up with an easy layup. Ball inbounded to Rowland. Rowland got him. And a pushing foul. Pushing foul was called on Garrett Taylor. Like Coach Thorpe told me to slow it down.
Yeah. No one to rush it.
And that would put Johnny Rowland to the line to shoot two. Sorry.
We had number 13.
Johnny Rowland.
For his first free throw attempt. It is no good.
Rebounded by Johnson. Thick Pen with the ball. Thick Pen passes Jacquez Jones. Jacquez Jones fakes. And it gets knocked out of bounds along with the foul. Jacquez Jones will go to the line and shoot his two. And Jacquez Jones goes up for his first free throw attempt. And it is good. With a lot of fan support.
It's a packed house tonight. Mainly for senior night. Also, shout out to the North Lawndale seniors.
Jones for another free throw attempt. It is good. Finley inbounds the ball to number 15, Ray Rushing. Ray Rushing guarded by Jacquez Jones. He passes to Rowland. Johnny Rowland guarded by Brandon Thorpe. See dribbles. He passes it to Rushing. Rushing to number 3, Moore. And the layup was missed. but put back in.
Nope,
no, it wasn't.
No good.
And it goes out of bounds.
And it will remain Englewood's ball. We have a minute and 31 seconds left in our first half. The score right now is 33-15.
That's rolling inbounds the ball to Jamie Finley. Jamie Finley guarded by Thick. And number 23 gets the easy layup, Montrell McLaurin. D'Angelo Thigpen with the ball. As he dribbles, he passes to Taylor. Taylor looks for the open man. He feeds it back to Thigpen. Thigpen looking to set up a play. Johnson with it. And this gets blocked
by Jamie Finley.
What a block. Rolling with the ball. Jamie Finley with the ball, looking for the shot, and it's no good. Picked up by Brandon Thorpe.
He's double teamed. He's gonna get a double.
He's calling on Brandon Thorpe.
It would be Englewood's ball.
As rolling inbounds the ball to number 23, McLaurin misses the shot. Rebounded by Jaquez Jones. Passes Johnson back to Jaquez Jones. Jaquez Jones.
And it is good.
And rolls in the basket. As he would go to the line and shoot one for a 3-point possession. Wow. Wow. Jaquez Jones really playing like a champ. I'm going to vote him for MVP.
I agree. And as he goes up for his first free throw attempt.
And it is
no good.
Rebounded by number 23, McLaurin. Rolling with the ball. He gets tripped up. McLaurin gets the pickup. And he's fouled. Corey, and he can go to the line to shoot one. Well, one for him. Montrell Lauren McLaurin goes up for his first free throw attempt, and it's good. Now he can get another one. As Corey McQuarrie goes to the bench, and for him is Jalen Smith. He makes the second one. Garrett Taylor feeds the ball to Johnson. Johnson for the easy layup, and it's dunk.
Good by
Johnson. Rolling passes it. And it gets blocked, thrown out of bounds.
And it will remain North Lawndale's ball.
Gary Taylor with the ball. He
with 20 seconds left.
Johnson. Taylor passes the ball to Jones. Jones looking to set up play. He passes it to Thorpe. Brandon Thorpe guarded by Jamie Finley. And it will remain North Lawndale's ball with 5 seconds left on the board. As Jalen Smith will take the ball out. Ball inbounded to Johnson. And it's stolen. Hand put up. Nearly made.
And that will conclude the first half, ladies and gentlemen. Score right now is 37-19. Score is now 37-19 for the North Lawndale Phoenix. How do you think the game is going, Detroit?
Well, it's a very interesting game. Seems like North Lawndale really came out here to play and win for that senior night. Englewood really need to pick up the pace, though.
Yeah, I agree. I think they need better defense. But right now, we're going to hand it over to our sideline reporter, Deshaun Henderson.
Hi, my name is Deshaun. I'm here with Coach Thorpe, the coach from North Lawndale. Tell us a little bit about senior night and why do you guys have it?
Well, you know, senior night is a really important night for our seniors. It gives them an opportunity to celebrate the time that they've been here at the school.
So what are you guys going to do differently during the second half?
Well, we're going to continue to do the same thing. They haven't stopped anything that we're doing. So, you know, we're just going to try to perfect what we're doing.
Okay, thank you and good luck. Now we're going to take a quick commercial break.
And number 23 gets the easy layup. pass it to Johnson. Back to Jaquez Jones. Jaquez Jones.
And it is good.
Number 23 goes for the shot.
And it is good.
Johnson for the easy layup. And it's dunk.
Can I have your autograph? Thank you, man.
All these years of playing ball, that's what it comes to.
Yeah, this is Hoops High. You know we got a wonderful show coming up. If you bring your game, we always gonna bring guys. And we doing something new this year. We gonna hype it up. Everything is upgraded to a new level. High school sports, we got a new thing going on now. We got the commentating, the audio and the video is so much better. And you gotta say the game's gonna be off the chain.
This is Hoops High and we're the best. We can lie, this is not a test. This is Hoops High and we're the best. We can lie, this is not a
test. Yeah, see, it's Hoops High, it's a brand new season, mini track, but we still are undefeated. See, commentators can't beat it, the AV is top seeded. We what the game's been missing, and we're the reason. So, you can catch us Saturday at 8, instead of watching BET, we take the cake, yeah.
This is Hoops High, and we're the best. We can lie, this is not a test. This is Hoops High, and we're the best. We can lie, this is not a test.
You see, players get messed up. They show you what bad is. Coaches put them in time out just like a bad kid. And high schoolers, yeah, we show you we are bad kids. Crossovers burn, you show you what a tan is. We keep the game fresh like a new tangerine. Hard hits leave them shaking up like a tambourine. I can keep talking or I can let Jasmine sing. I'ma stop talking and I'ma let Jasmine sing.
This is
on the sidelines, our unseen cast, which is Crystal Frills and Ashley Schaefer. Okay, you got her. Marshawn, I see you out there, baby. All the time, anytime. And just get ready for the show. It's going to be nice.
This is Derrick Rose from the Chicago Bulls, and you're watching Hoops High.
Hi, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome back to Hoops High. We are about to kick off the second half of the North Lawndale Phoenix versus Team Englewood game. It's been very interesting. Good defense has been played by the North Lawndale Phoenix. The score right now is 37-19. Natural, you have anything to say about the first quarter?
Well, I think I pretty much summed it up in the first half, but man, North Lawndale playing very good basketball, and Englewood needs to step their game up if they want to stay in the game. Mm-hmm.
I agree. But right now they're doing a little presentation with the cheerleaders. And also honoring Jimmy Williams. That would be Jimmy Williams, North Lawndale's third all-time leading scorer. He's playing overseas. He's back here in America, so we're welcoming him back. And we are about to kick off our second half. Teams right now are meeting up before we get back into it.
Here we go, second in the blue uniforms, Team Englewood, in the front. Senior night from North London Conference Prep. The cheerleaders, the pom-pom, and the varsity basketball players singing, here we come, here we come, here we come.
As you can see, Corey McCray will inbound the ball for North London.
Every Saturday night,
ball inbounded to D'Angelo Digpin. Digpin guarded by Roland. Feeds the ball to Jaquez Jones. Jonah passes to Thorpe, holding him with the ball. McQuarrie, seems like North Lawndale passing game. McQuarrie goes all the way, and he gets this layup. Jamie Finley takes the ball out. Ball inbounded to Roland. Roland dribbles the ball up. Roland guarded by D'Angelo Thigpen as he dribbles in a pick was set, but not made. Roland goes up for the shot, and it's no good. Rebounded by Jacquez Jones. Brandon Thorpe with the ball. He passes it. Holding. Jamie Finley guarded by Jacquez Jones. And he passes it to Roland. Back to Finley. Finley looking for the open man as he feeds it. And the shot was put up, but missed. Holding with another block. D'Angelo Thigpen gets the ball as he dribbles. Passes it to Brandon Thorpe. Brandon Thorpe for a three, and it's no good. He saves it, passes it to Holden. Holden goes to work, and he put the ball where it needs to be. Coaches and the bench.
Yeah, everybody's getting excited. North Lawndale really playing hard tonight. Score right now is 43-19. 6 minutes and 33 seconds left.
As a pushing foul, and the pushing foul is called on D'Angelo Thigpen, Englewood will keep possession of the ball. As the ball was inbounded to Roland. Roland for the shot, and it's no good. Rebounded by the number three and put in at number 32, D'Angelo Rockamore. Corey McCrary for a shot, and it's no good. And a foul was called. Wow.
Jamie Finley will inbound the ball, and it would go to Brandon Thorpe, intended for Englewood, and Jacquez goes up for the layup, but it's no good.
He rolls it, but misses it. Holding with the steal, passes to Jacquez Jones, as he passes it to Thigpen. Passes it to Jacquez Jones. Jacquez Jones feeds it to Brandon Thorpe. Thorpe goes all the way and gets the foul. He's going to the line to shoot two, ladies and gentlemen.
Yes, and please check out the Free Spirit Media website at www.freespiritmedia.org or check us out, Hoops High, at www.hoopshigh.org. We have Brandon Thorpe at the line as he gets ready to go up for his first free throw attempt. And it is no good. And they made a substitution. Devontae Johnson will be coming in for Jacquez Jones. Pardon me, D'Angelo Thigpen.
And the block was put up and knocked out of bounds.
Rowland inbounds the ball. Missed shot by number 32, D'Angelo Rockamore.
Ball inbound. Rolling with the ball. He goes up for the three, and it gets blocked by the big man and saved by
Holden. And Jock goes up for the layup, and it's good.
Jamie Finley takes the ball out. Ball inbounded to Rolling.
Good play by North Lawndale Phoenix. Shout out to DeAndre Holden.
Yeah, what a play. Rolling passes the ball. He goes up. Jamie goes up for the three, and it's no good. And an over-the-back foul is called.
Yes, and the PSAs, dramas, and documentaries that you see between breaks on Hoops High are produced by Free Spirit Media students at North Lawndale College Prep, the Gary Comer Youth Center, Powerhouse High, and Weston House College Prep. We hope that you enjoy the stories and messages that we young people are sharing.
As Roland has possession of the ball, Roland feeds the ball number 23. McLaurin back to Roland. and the shot was jacked up but missed. Brandon Thorpe dribbles the ball. Pushes the ball up court, and it goes out of bounds, and it will be a turnover. Englewood's ball.
Rowland brings the ball up court for Team Englewood.
Rowland passes the ball, and the three was jacked up by number 25, but missed. Ball, rebound. And it was tipped in by number 32, D'Angelo Rockamore. Jaquez Jones with the ball. Jaquez Jones has the ball to Johnson. Johnson goes to the right. Goes around the pick, and he goes all the way. And
it's good.
Good. What a floater. Rollin has possession of the ball. Passes it to Finley. Finley guarded by Jones, back to Rowland. And it's stolen by Jaquez Jones. Jaquez Jones gets the foul. Wow, mama, look at that man again.
That mama.
That's good sportsmanship was shown by Johnny Rowland helping Jaquez Jones up. What we like to see.
I always like to see good sportsmanship.
Yes. Jaquez Jones go to the line to shoot his two.
Jaquez Jones getting ready to go for his first free throw attempt. And it is good.
First one is good.
Jaquez Jones again as he prepares for his second free throw attempt.
Jaquez Jones goes.
And that is good as well.
Rowland with the ball. She goes up for fake. Rowland guarded by number one, Jalen Smith. And it was thrown out of bounds to the bench. It's North Lawndale will have possession of the ball. But a timeout was called. North Lawndale's bench.
A full timeout. All right, now we're going to take you to a quick commercial break. You're watching Hoops High.
Who is this fool, man?
This ain't that kind of fuck.
This week, man.
Huh? Hey,
you think
it's
sweet?
Fuck this, man. Right away, man.
Hey, little bro. What's going on with you, man? Nah, I was messing with you.
Hey, I'm two-time Olympian and former NFL football player Jeremy Bloom, and you are watching Hoops High.
Ladies and gentlemen, to the North Lawndale versus Englewood game. We are here at the Collins campus in the middle of our third quarter. We have 3 minutes and 47 seconds left. The score right now is 49-23, and North Lawndale is in the lead.
And turnover, North Lawndale's ball. And Jalen Smith will take the ball out. Ball inbounded to Johnson. Devontae Johnson with the ball. Hits Jalen Smith. Jalen Smith misses it. Open layup.
He gets hit in the face. Wiping it off. I think he got hit in his eye, actually. It'll be all right. Rowland with the ball. He brings it up court for Team Englewood.
He passes to Jamie Finley. Jamie Finley gets the double team. Feeds it to Rowland. And it's stolen by number 33, Antoine Smith. Johnson with the ball.
What the way,
he gets the ball back. As he dribbles, he's looking for the open play. He goes around the pick. feeds it to Garrett Taylor. Garrett Taylor for a three, and it's no good. Rebounded by Rylan. Rylan with the ball. She brings up court. Rylan guarded by Smith. And it's a shot. Go Zoom. Johnson with the ball. He goes for the fake. Passes it. Smith misses a three. Rebounded by the big guy, number three, Chetone Moore. Rylan with the ball. Passes to Jamie Finley. And it's stolen by Garrett Taylor. But it gets stolen right back by number 33, Rockamore. Rebounded. Grayson. Fronte passes the ball.
Goes up and the shot is good.
Easy layup.
Yes, and if you just can't seem to get enough of Hoops High, friend us on Facebook, get to know the crew and what goes into every Hoops High production. You can also check out some of our videos on YouTube. Go to www.youtube.com and search for FSM Hoops High.
It's Montrell McLaurin, misses a three. It's rebounded and put back in. Whoa, it's missed. It's knocked out of bounds.
And it would be North Lawndale's ball.
Timeout was called. With a timeout, we're going to talk to commercial.
You are watching Hoops High.
Oh, I love basketball. Then, I got the opportunity to go pro. After thinking about it, I considered it. But did I make the right choice?
What's up? This is Larry Hughes. You're watching Hoops High.
And welcome back to Hoops High, ladies and gentlemen. We have a minute and 42 seconds left in our third quarter. Score right now is 51-25. And North Lawndale is in the lead of Team Englewood. Mitchell, how do you think this game is going to turn out?
Well, seems like it's definitely going to go North Lawndale's way, but it's still possible.
Yeah, it's very possible.
But it'll take a lot of effort from Team Englewood.
Yes, I agree. Let's get back into the game.
Taylor with the ball. Taylor looks for the open man. He feeds it to Smith. Smith guarded by Russia as he dribbles. Passes it to Keith. Garrett Taylor with the ball. Garrett Taylor, look. Pass and the ball is put where it needs to be by Antoine Smith. Rolling with the ball. Rolling guarded by. Rolling gets the ball. It's pass number 23. And the shot was put up and in by the big guy, number 32, D'Angelo Rockamore. Garrett Taylor with the ball. Garrett Taylor guarded by Jamie Finley, and he puts up the layup, and it's missed. Rebound by the freshman, and he gets the foul. As he will go to the line and shoot two. The score is 53-27, 34 seconds left in the third quarter.
Also, Free Spirit Media works with students at the Gary Como Youth Center to produce a talk and news show and news magazine called Perspectives of Teens in Chicago. Make sure you check them out on YouTube as well.
As Johnny Rowland will go to the bench, and for him is number one, Wendell.
Oh my God, Nicky.
As he goes up for a second free throw attempt, and it's good. Jamie Smith mounts the ball. Ball pass. Jamie Finley with the ball. He feeds the ball to the number one, back to Jamie Finley. Goes up for the shot and he gets the foul.
by the number 21 Keith Max. That's his second attempt. And the 29 senior Jamie Fenton.
As Jamie Finley goes up for his first free throw attempt, and it is good. And number 32 gets the foul, D'Angelo Rockamore. As number 32 goes up for us, free throw attempt, and it's good. Oh, they inbounds the ball to Smith. Smith dribbles the ball, passes it to Taylor. Taylor looks for the open man. Taylor guarded by number 23, McLaurin. As he passes number 40, number 40 for the shot, and it gets blocked. And that's the end of the third quarter.
Our third quarter, and we're going to toss it over to our sideline reporter, Daisha Henderson.
Good.
Hi, my name is Daisha, and I'm here with Precious Henderson, alumni of Hoops High. Seeing that this is your senior year and your first year without Hoops High, how do you feel about it?
Well, I feel like being with Hoops High, it really taught me a lot about digital media, and it really felt like I was at home here. Like, I really felt like I was a part of everything, working with the crew, broadcasting and all that. It was really nice. I really miss you guys.
So what do you think is North Lawndale's weakness and strength today?
Well, the strength is having Jaquez Jones, DeAndre Holden, Devontae Johnson, players like them, efficient players like that. Yeah, they're doing their thing out there. We used to have Jamie Finley on the team, but now he's on the other team, so we really miss him, but that's why they're losing.
All right, thank you. Now we're going to toss it back to the announcers.
And we're going to kick off our fourth quarter, ladies and gentlemen, as Jamie Finley inbounds the ball
to Johnny Rowland. Rowland guarded by Thigpen as the starting lineup for North Lawndale is back in. Finley guarded by Jaquez Jones, and it's a double team. Loose ball. Jaquez Jones gets the pick up. He goes for the shot, and it's
good.
And the ball is fed to number one. He Wendell go and he misses the shot. And Team Englewood will keep possession of the ball.
Yes, we have 7 minutes and 31 seconds left in our fourth quarter. The score right now is 57-31. North Lawndale is up.
Wendell goes up for a three. This time it's good. Holden inbounds the ball to Thigpen. Thigpen guarded by Johnny Rowland. Beat Thorpe with the ball. Pass it to McQuarrie. McQuarrie feeds the ball to Holden. Holden for the dunk, and it's good. And the crowd goes wild. And the crowd goes wild. What a dunk by Holden. He jumped from another state. Wow. And he gets the foul.
As DeAndre Holden goes up for his first free throw attempt, and it is good.
What a dunk.
I think he would be my key player of the game. I just see the replay on the screen. Beautiful dunk.
No, Fonda's showing tremendous hustle. D'Angelo Thigpen with the ball. He feeds it to Thorpe. Thorpe for the layup, and it's put back in by Corey McQuarrie. Jamie Finley will come down to take the ball out for Team Englewood.
They're going to have number 15 at the line.
Number 25.
Jamie Finley at the line for Team Englewood.
Oh,
It's a lot of energy in this house tonight.
That dunk really brought the energy.
Yeah, it really did. Everybody stood up. Everybody was on their toes. Jamie Finley with his first free throw attempt, and it is good.
Hey, what number was that first one?
Jamie Finley misses his second free throw attempt, and Corey McCrary has the ball.
Corey McCrary guarded by number one, Wendell. Corey McCrary gets the foul. Sorry, he would take the ball out.
Number one brings the ball up court for Englewood.
As he passes number 15, Ray Rushing goes up for the shot, and it's no good, but put.
Nope. Yes. Reject. Gary Taylor brings the ball up for North Lawndale.
Corey McCrary feeds the ball to Thorpe. Thorpe to Holden. Holden for the shot, and it's good. Holden came here to play. And it's nearly stolen by Brandon Thorpe, but a jump ball was called.
North Lawndale bench, and also fans are very excited right now. Score is 66-35. We have 6 minutes and 11 seconds left in the fourth quarter.
Jaquez Jones for the fake. He goes up for the shot, and it's no good. Rebounded by the big guy. Rolling with the ball. He goes he passes it, and it gets knocked out of bounds. Queen Englewood will keep possession of the ball. Jamie Finley double team. And it's stolen. But this gets still back, and it's stolen by Gary Taylor. Gary Taylor to Jaquez Jones. Jones for the layup, and it's good. And here we go to the line and make it a 3-point play.
Man, I'm really enjoying this game today, Detroit. How about you?
Man, very interesting game.
And you see the replay with Jaquez with the easy layup.
Honestly, I think this is probably the most exciting game I have been to where I haven't seen North Lawndale this year.
Yeah, I definitely have to agree. As Jaquez Jones goes up for his first free throw attempt.
And it is good. Rolling with the ball. Rolling passes the ball, number 25, and it's rejected. And it's another turnover, Corey McCrary, but he steps out of bounds. He steps on the line, and it will go to Team Englewood.
I don't think that would affect North Lawndale in any way right now.
Tell him the score to go.
The score is 69-35, ladies and gentlemen.
Johnny Rowland with the ball. Johnny Rowland passes the ball, number 15, Ray Rushing. Ray Rushing, double team, looking for the open man, and stolen by Jaquez Jones once again. He goes all the way. And he misses, but gets fouled, and he will go to land and shoot two.
Ladies and gentlemen, Free Spirit Media strives to give students a voice and is associated with True Star Magazine. You can check them out at www.truestaris.com. Remember, True Star is where teens speak the truth. Check out the Hoops High Hype column in True Star Magazine as well. Jaquez Jones for his free throw attempt, and it is good. We have Jaquez Jones again for his second free throw attempt.
He goes,
and that is good as well. 2 for 2.
Ball inbound to Johnny Rowland. Johnny Rowland putting in a lot of minutes this game. He feeds number 22, Jamie Finley, for a three, and it is good. his foot was on the line. They were counting for a two-point possession. Brandon Thorpe for the pump fake. He misses.
Saved by Jacquez Jones.
Jacquez Jones fakes him. Passes to Holden. Holden for the steal, but a traveling violation was called.
Yes. Also, we know we are not always perfect, but we are working hard and we are always learning. We thank you for your support and encouragement.
Jamie Finley for another three, and this miss rebounded by Brandon Thorpe. Thorpe passes it to Holden, but it's stolen by Jamie Finley. Jamie Finley pushes the ball down court as he will go all the way and doesn't get it. Rebounded by Garrett Taylor. As he passes to Jacquez Jones. Jacquez Jones looking to score, and it goes off his leg, and it will be turnovers.
We have 4 minutes and 27 seconds remaining in the fourth quarter, ladies and gentlemen. The score right now is 71 to 38.
Rolling with the ball. Pass number 22, Owens. Rolling for a three, and it's no good. Rebounded by Holden. Taylor with the ball. So he brings it up court. Taylor guarded by Finley. He goes around the pick. Pass to Jacquez Jones. Jones for a three, and it's no good. Rebounded by number 22, Owens. Jonathan Owens with the ball. She pushes it up court, nearly stolen. Feeds it to number one, Wendell for a three, and it's no good. Rebounded and put back in by the big guy, D'Angelo Rockamore. Corey McCrary calling for the ball. Pass it to Gary Taylor. Gary Taylor looking for the open man. She dribbles. He goes up for the shot.
And it's good.
It's good. Johnny Owens with the ball. Johnny Owens looking to pass the ball. He passed to Roland, and it was knocked out of bounds. As Jamie Finley inbounds the ball to Johnny Roland. Roland, sorry. Rolling dribbles. Rolling past the ball to Finley. Finley gets the ball back past the roller. Feeds it to Wendell. Wendell goes for the roll, and it's no good. Holding the grass to Reeves. Pass it to Garrett Taylor. Garrett Taylor dribbles. He feeds it to McCrary. McCrary for a three, and it's no good. Ball went out of bounds, bounces out of bounds, take a big bounce. Jamie Finley will take the ball out.
Yes. And we had 2 minutes and 48 seconds remaining in the game. Score right now is 73 to 40. North Lawndale, of course, is up.
As Brandon Thorpe gets the foul.
Yes, and don't forget to stay tuned for the Free Spirit Media News at the end of this broadcast. It comes on at 9:50 every Saturday. Learn about what's going on in Chicago and find out the latest and most important issues with teams.
Johnny Rowland goes up for his free throw attempt. His first free throw attempt is good, and that will send him for another one. He goes up for a second free throw attempt, and it's good. Garrett Taylor with the ball. Garrett Taylor guarded by Johnny Rowland. He passed to Corey McCrary. Corey McCrary for the pump fake. It feeds the ball to Jacquez Jones. Jones with the ball. Passes it to McCrary. McCrary for another shot, and it's no good. Rebounded, but put back in by DeAndre Holden. Johnny Rowland with the ball. He gets the double team.
Out of bounds.
Holden trying to get the steal, but it goes out of bounds, and it will stay Team Englewood's ball. Jacquez Jones with the steal. He passed to Holden. Holden for another dunk, and it's good. That guy's jumping out the building.
And there's a timeout call, ladies and gentlemen. We're going to take you to a quick commercial break. You are watching Hoops High.
for you to go out there and I'm going to need for you to play real good and real hard. I don't care about any excuses. You need to come on and play now.
Hi, I'm Ian Thorpe, five-time Olympic gold medalist, and you're watching Hoops High.
And you see the replay on the screen. Welcome back.
And the ball was thrown out of bounds. And it was State Team Englewood's ball. And it's stolen by Malcolm. Malcolm missed the foul and the easy layup. He would go to the line and shoot just one.
Yeah, Malcolm Boyd at the line as he gets ready to go up for his first free throw attempt, and it is good.
Brandon with the steal. Malcolm gets it, and he passes to Jacquez Jones. I'm sorry, number 32.
That was Jacquez too.
Keith Mack. Brandon Thorpe goes up for the shot. That's number 10. It's an easy layup. Ashton Hiller. Garrett Taylor with the ball. He's double teamed. He passes it to number 32. 32 fakes. Goes all the way, and it's good. Easy bucket. And it's stolen by Malcolm. Malcolm passes it to Garrett Taylor. Holden gets the ball, and he gets fouled. Holden goes to the line to shoot his free throw. Holden goes up for the free throw attempt, and it's no good. Rebound and put back up. Number 32. Dante Martinez. Ball pass. Malcolm gets the rebound. He feeds it to Brandon Thorpe. Brandon Thorpe takes the foul, and he will go to the line. As he makes his, he misses his first free throw attempt.
We have Brandon Thorpe at the line. Also, it's 32 seconds left. The score is 85 to 44. Blow out.
And it's rebounded by the freshman, Marquise Jefferson. Brandon Thorpe with the ball. He goes up for the shot.
It's no good.
Rebounded by the freshman. Once again. Garrett Taylor feeds the ball to Marquise. Passes the ball. It's stolen. With 4 seconds left, throws up the last shot. And it's no good.
Gentlemen, score is 85-44. North Lawndale has taken this win. It's been overall a great game. My key player for this game would have to be senior DeAndre Holden. He's big man tonight.
Jacquez Jones. I gotta go with Jacquez Jones. He really put some good buckets in.
Yeah, he did. But DeAndre, like, came the second half, he just went insane.
Yeah, Holden put some buckets in. He brought a lot of energy to the crowd, but A lot of them points on the board really came from Jack West Jones. But yeah, that was a very good team effort.
Yeah, they really played. I really like what I saw from the North Lawndale Phoenix tonight. Yes. Also, shout out to Team Englewood. You all did is pretty good as well.
Yeah, they came out. Each team came out to play, but North Lawndale won the victory and they got it.
Yeah, I agree. Well, that will conclude our game. Thank you for watching Hoops High. Right now, we're gonna toss it over to our sideline reporter, Deshaun Henderson.
Hi, my name is Deshaun. I'm here with the player of the game, Jaquez. So seeing that this is your last home game, how do you feel about it?
I feel good. I feel like I played good on my last game at home.
So what is your mindset for the state finals?
My mindset, we're going to beat everybody and we're going to make it downstate.
So what are your plans seeing that you are a senior? What colleges are you looking at?
I don't know yet. I might be looking at a junior college right now.
All right, thank you. So there you have it. North Lawndale has took the victory. Stay tuned for more Hoops High next week.
He's number 22, Jamie Finney, for a three, and this is
good.
Holding for the dunk, and it's good. And the crowd goes wild. Window goes up for a three. This time, it's good. It's Jaquez Jones. Jones for the layup, and it's good.
You can watch Hoops High on CAN-TV, Channel 19, every Saturday at 8 p.m. Please visit www.hoopshigh.org to learn more. Hoops High and Free Spirit Media would like to thank our sponsors. We are grateful for their support in making our mission of youth media education and opportunity possible.
Never was exposed to it, they probably would have never have done it, but it's something that you see that interests people a lot.
I never worked with a camera, you know, my first time learning about a camera, you know, zooming in, zooming out. It was a real good experience for me, you know. I think it changed a lot in me too. It changed my how I think, and it changed like something I like to do in life.
When I get older, I want to be some type of actor. So being in this classroom really helped me out, really exercise my ability to act.
We shooting it and we shooting it off like what we done been through, and like people get to see it and they watching it and they liking it.
Like young kids in the community can do stuff that's like worth some type of value.
Do you believe I mean I created equal? What about women? Do you believe they are created equal?
More than one in four teenagers in a relationship report enduring repeated verbal or physical abuse. If trapped in an abusive relationship, 73% of teens said that they would turn to a friend for help, but only 33% who have been in or known about an abusive relationship said that they told anyone about it. One in three teenagers reports knowing a friend or peer who has been hit, punched, kicked, or physically hurt by their partner. It's your voice. Use it.
Dear fathers, remember when the community was filled with black men who weren't afraid to lead? They built strong households, which made our community stronger. Now, the 21st century, things have terribly changed. Black communities lacking men in the households, which is dividing parents and teens. Teens having a lack of guidance with no support. And the young ladies looking for fathers in all the wrong places. And the young black men have continued to take a back seat in society and fall beneath their potentials.
Some of the things that cause parents and teens not to get along is understanding versus understood, I think. I think a lot of the youth feel misunderstood. Parents, a lot of times they saying they need to be understood and telling the teen, you better understand. But as a teen, you changing, you know, the parents gotta understand teens are teenagers. They changing emotionally, they changing mentally, they changing physically, they thinking, they mindset is totally different from that little JoJo when he was 9 and 10 and 11.
Dear mothers, nobody know what goes on in my home. It seems like everything I do is wrong. The conflict between my mother and I hurts my heart. But she can just understand that all I need for her to do is spend some quality time with me, and everything will be all right.
You got a mom that comes home from work, she's tired, she probably had, there's no telling what went on at the workplace. You get home, you got a teen, haven't done anything she asks. House full of company, TV on, it's a mess from front to back, everybody eating up the groceries she bought, and they can't understand why mama is upset, and they can't understand why she's not, you know, okay with this going on, and all she wants is a house clean, no children here, and just do what I ask, just a little peace and calm. But they teenagers, so they need this outlet, they need friends, they need company, they need to be messy, they need to come in and just throw the book over here and throw something over there and just be. But as parents, we want some control, and when we see that we don't have control, we get upset.
The blame is on me. Only one responsible for this is me. You say this is all my fault, but Mama, I didn't get pregnant by myself. I'm alone without your love and your help.
They want to become their own person. They want to become independent. It's like a two-year-old. Mom, I can do this. You have taught me everything I need. I don't need you anymore. They're trying to gain their freedom and their independence. And parents, they know they're not ready. So we hold on to with everything we can, because our job is to protect them, and they don't understand that. They think our job is to hold them back, when actually we know how rough it is and how the world is out there, and we know it's a lot more in them that they need to go out there to meet the world.
Mama, I've been trying so hard to finish school, but every time I come in the house, I end up fighting with you. I'm here to stay, I'm tired of all the drama. Mama, I wish that we could build our mother and son relationship, because Mama, I love you and I want to get to know you.
Mom, you're too old, you don't know what's going on. Oh, Dad, you don't know what's going on, you're too old. But the reality is, your parents have been through the same thing, just a different flavor. And when that comes around, children are not listening to the wisdom because they think their parents don't know what's going on. They make a lot of mistakes that their parents could tell them that they wouldn't have to make if they were listening.
Dear community, we're dropping out of school being another statistic. There goes another black teen not being realistic.
For the most part, it's going to take two families in order to raise a household. And sometimes when the two families is out working, they have a tendency to allow the teens be by themselves too much. And now all of a sudden, a teen is being educated and raised by video games, some influence from the streets. And quite naturally, when that happens, it's always going to generate some misunderstanding.
Parents working so hard, not paying enough attention, missing out on their teens' life grows more and more tension.
But if you got a good, strong foundation and you got a two-family household with the father, he's going to work, the mom going to work, there's no real conflict with them. And each parent is backing each other up on the decision they make about the child, I don't see too much conflict. But with teens, it's always one because they want their way.
This affects me, this affects you, this affects our whole community.
I wasn't ready.
She told me she was ready.
I just did it because he wanted to.
She told me she was ready, so I asked no questions.
I regret making that decision.
It was the best sex ever.
I told him I wasn't ready.
I told her I would wait then.
He didn't even pressure me. He said we're gonna take our time.
I took her by the hand and told her we was gonna take it slow. Communication is the key to a healthy relationship.
Wait, y'all, I forgot my jacket. I'm gonna get up with y'all later.
Okay.
Hey, girl.
The lights in here, baby.
Trust is gone in the relationship. I don't feel like you can gain it back.
I mean, you gotta have a relationship, and a relationship has to start somewhere, and you build love, you don't build money.
I think that to gain and build trust in a relationship, people have to first and foremost really know what they want from that relationship and what their expectations are of their partner, because that will allow them to be able to trust them.
If you really love that person, or you really feel for that person, they can make a mistake, and if you're confident in who you are, and again, if you feel for that person, I think you can build trust again. It may take a while, but I think once it's been broken, you can build it up.
I don't think so, because the human mind is a very particular object that holds on to things, and memory is the most powerful thing in the world today. So things you remember stick with you forever.
To me, I see basically unhealthy relationships because it's a lot be going out here with cheating, abuse, and others not getting along, families and stuff like that, breaking up and stuff like that.
Relationships, why women show lack of jealousy. I mean, you know you pretty. People may say you ugly, but deep inside you know you pretty, so be yourself. Don't get jealous. If the dude ain't right for you, then just leave it alone. There's a lot of dudes, and eventually you'll find the right one for you.
Society teaches young men that to be a man, you have to be strong and you can't show emotion. And so I think that men are taught and they get made fun of and are not accepted if they show emotion. And I think that's a structural change in our society that needs to happen. Our society really needs to think about how we start supporting young men, because young men need supports. They need people they can talk to, and they need to be allowed to show emotions, because it's not healthy to hold stuff in.
You can build and gain trust in relationships in a lot of ways. One way you can do it is kind of be more open, because with males and females, they tend to hold in a lot of feelings, especially males, because from the way they raised, they taught to kind of mask their feelings, you know, kind of like, you know, through anger or sometimes through pain, and sometimes they don't really know how to show it. So one way you can kind of do that is kind of be more open, though, not really be scared to show your feelings, because if this person really loves you, and if y'all really in love, y'all should be able to express yourself through any type of way, because you should be able to accept the person that you love.
Because especially for women, it's hard to, you can forgive somebody, but you can't really forget what they've done to break that trust. So you may trust them a little bit, but it'll never be like exactly the same as what it was.
Raise your kids the right way. Don't raise your little boys to grow up, be all hardcore stuff. Let them show their soft side. Let your females cover their bodies. Don't expose their bodies to people they don't even know of. People in general, let them grow up the way they want to grow up. Just show respect. Be that healthy role model that you want yourself to be, your child to be, and so forth.
Y'all need probable cause to search her.
Police do a lot of good things in regards to the CAPS program and other community outreach programs that they do. Some of the police are very exceptional in the way that they treat our youth. However, on the other side of the coin, some of these police is rotten as shit, especially Dirty Red.
My grandson is 4 years old and is afraid of the police.
They're supposed to be protecting us, but I feel like we getting arrested more than we getting protected, so the police don't mean nothing to me.
Dirty Red will put dope on these boys around here, and he will take and set them up and send them to jail.
I believe that African-American brothers are being targeted, not only in my community, but at large.
Where I'm from, the police patrol my neighborhood night and day.
Yet we still find many bodies laying in the back of the alleyway.
Most of the police are white. I'm a black man. They don't quite know who and what I am and what I do.
Police are riding out on young men merely because they're standing on the corner. But what else do they do if you don't have any community centers, if you don't have any basketball courts? I mean, what can you do? You know what I'm saying? Men gonna gather. We've always been tribal individuals, so it's in our instinct to be in groups and things of this nature.
Where I'm from, programs like DR are ran by the police to keep the young off the street. But yet they still find some time to pack some heat.
They're kind of like an army in the communities, right? And their purpose is to protect people's property, right? Well, usually poor people don't own property, so they don't protect poor people and low-income people. They protect rich people.
The police try and enforce laws that are broken because people are poor. I don't think it's the police's problem to solve tension problems. It's a problem of the powers that be provide jobs for people so they don't commit crime, so they're no need for heavy police presence.
Where I'm from, the police definitely seems to care.
Yeah, tons of bullets find time to fly through the air.
Unfortunately, each and every citizen here in our community are viewed either as a drug dealer or a gang banger, and of course that's not the case. We do have working class people.
Sometimes the police, in trying to do their job, generalize and see all young people, in particular young black and Latino people, as a threat, right? So if you're walking down the street, they ignore your rights and they stop you and ask you where you're going, even if you're not doing anything.
But they get pulled over and disrespected and patted down. And I don't appreciate that at all.
Where I'm from, police are always on speed dial.
Yeah, arrive at the crime at the wrong time.
They can stem from the police not respecting our young adults. Everyone in the community is not, like I said, doing bad things. And if you ride up on a young man that's minding his business playing basketball and call him all type of B's and H's and punks and the N-words, you know, next time that young man see you, he's gonna be like, "El the police," or "Kiss man this, kiss that." I think it's a respect. If you don't show respect, you can't get respect, and they go on both ends.
They tend to look down on the black community as if it's nothing. So I believe that I cannot change their mind no matter what.
Where we from, it's kinda hard to make a change, but we know it can be accomplished if we all think the same.
Honestly speaking, one part of me, the militant aspect, would rather say let's start up in the realm of revolution. Revolution itself don't mean just to pick up arms. Revolution means change. And again, I believe we can talk it out, we can work it out.
In this year alone in Chicago, we've had 34 Chicago public school students gunned down and killed. In this year alone. And for the most part, there has been silence. We know what to do. It's already been mentioned. We've got to enforce the gun laws that are on the books. We've got to make sure that unscrupulous gun dealers aren't loading up vans and dumping guns in our communities, because we know they're not made in our communities.
I'm not beautiful like her. I'm not beautiful like her.
Did you know that an average teen spends about $85 per week on material items? Which means the current teen economy tops $141 billion.
Money and materials don't make you. You make you.
Hello, and welcome to FSM News. I am Janelle Coleman.
And I'm Rosie Martin. FSM News is a product of Free Spirit Media, which is a nonprofit organization that empowers youth voice.
In this week's newscast, we will be focused on teens and their addictions.
That's right. There seems like there's so much that teens are addicted to. Can you think of anything that teens might be addicted to?
Well, texting is the one that immediately comes to mind.
That's right. Teens have turned text language into their own proper English. I have more on this story. Stay tuned.
Most students are taught the English language, and for some, even Spanish. But there is a unique language that is spreading through our teens today, text language. Although it's a simple language, texting is growing into something with a big impact. Some people may say it's a negative one. Our teens today are misusing proper English for text language, but the main question is, why?
You can speak it quicker and people know the meaning of it.
For teens, text language is slowly but surely becoming a new proper English.
Because you shorten words, you don't spell the words the correct way, you don't spell them out, and you don't use correct grammar half the time when you text.
Text language, proper English, there's a debate on which is best or when it is right to use either one. For FSM News, I'm Rosie Martin.
Before we take a break, we will introduce you to some of the top 10 teen addictions.
according to an addiction expert who supports teens through a program called The Power of Choice. The number 10 teen addiction is S-E-X. That's right, sex. Let's hope that teens are practicing safe sex. Number 9 is self-harm.
Number 8 is undereating or anorexia. Number 7 is overeating. And number 6 is sugary candy.
Stay with us after the break and we will reveal to you the next top 5.
Hold on, let me check my Twitter.
Well, you need to hurry up.
Hold on, let me check my Facebook.
You know, Dominique, we should go out and go watch a movie or something.
Yeah.
You know, go out to eat.
Mm-hmm. Before we go, I need to check my Twitter.
Okay, but you said that like an hour ago.
It's only gonna take a minute.
You know, give me this.
What?
You really have a problem. Like, we really need to fix this. We need to go out and hang out and do something. Come on.
Thanks for staying with us.
Now for the top 5 things that teens are addicted to. Number 5 is cigarettes. Number 4 is alcohol. 3, marijuana. 2 is internet or social networks.
And now for the number 1 teen addiction. Can you guess what it is? If you thought Flamin' Hot Doritos or any other salty, sweet, or spicy junk food, you're right. Here's FSM Tavashine Brown with more.
Chocolate. I love chocolate.
Mostly ice cream and chips.
Chocolate chip cookies.
And McDonald's, White Castles, and Wendy's.
2 honey buns, 2 juices, and yes, some cookies.
Junk food has become a major addiction for teens, so much that it becomes a part of their daily diet. Why are so many teens addicted to these unhealthy foods?
Because it tastes good. It feels good, you know?
It's right there in our neighborhood, right there at the gas station at our corner store, easy for us to go pick up. It's only $1.
Now I can see why so many teens are addicted to junk food. With a taste so good, most teens say they can't go long without eating it.
Maybe 2 weeks, but that's it.
Like 3 days.
Whole 2 days.
5 minutes.
Regardless of what type of junk food it is, one thing for sure is that it keeps teens coming back for more. Some teens believe they could kick the addiction if they only had a little more help.
Their parents haven't been teaching them about how to eat the healthy foods. Mm-hmm. And so they never learned.
We don't know who's to blame for the number 1 teen addiction, but we do know that teens are probably already planning their next junk food attack.
I was thinking about going to McDonald's actually after this.
For FSM News, I'm Tavashine Brown.
If you'd like to find out more about the top 10 teen addictions, please visit the website, thepowerofchoice.ca.
Up next in Teen Talk, we decided to go out and talk to some teens ourselves about what their addictions are.
I'm addicted to texting, for one. Talking on the phone, too, and Facebook, 3. Because I'm a teenager, it's like what we do, it's our nature.
I'm addicted to candy and texting. Texting because I can't live without communicating with my friends because at home is really boring. And I can't just sit at home and just talk to my aunt and uncle because they get on my nerves.
They're boring.
So like if I didn't have texting and like phones or whatever.
We would die.
Right.
We would die.
We would die.
I'm addicted to the internet because I'm on 24/7. It's on my phone. I got a laptop. And I'm on it every time I go home.
I'm addicted to Facebook because it's a social network. And like, if I don't have my phone or if my friends, if they don't have their phone, then they could just get on Facebook and talk on Facebook. Like, everybody on there.
To my cell phone because I feel like I always got to text my friends or talk on the phone to them to keep them updated.
Well, me personally, I feel I'm addicted to electronics. I got to be on the computer. I got to listen to some music. I gotta be on the phone. I gotta do something that's electronic.
Up next, we will have a quiz to test your knowledge on the most destructive habits.
The numbers are quite shocking. We'll be right back.
I gotta beat you, boy. Break him.
Wait. You don't ever spend time with me.
Look, this is business.
When was the last time we went out?
This is.
When was the last time we went out?
Does it matter? We're out now.
Come on.
Baby, you need to realize what it is. Pool is my life.
You know, I'm surprised that video games did not make the list. When a lot of teens are not texting, they're still playing video games on their cell phones.
Well, actually, video games made the top 12, and you'll be surprised at how many students actually play video games on their computers or their cell phones. FSM News, Vanetta Sim, has a quiz on some of the shocking statistics.
Hi, I'm Vanetta Sims, and today I'm going to quiz you on some popular addictive behaviors. Here's question number one. How many hours on average does a teen spend playing online video games by the age of 21? Is it A, 5,000 hours, B, 2,000 hours, or C, 10,000 hours? If you answered C, 10,000 hours, you are correct. Question number two. Which of these are not a part of the top 10 signs of a cell phone addiction? Is it A, full battery doesn't last all day, B, it feels like your phone is vibrating when it actually isn't, or C, you have many different apps and you use them all? If you answer B, it feels like your phone is vibrating when it's not, you've answered correctly. Question number three. How many photos and videos do you think are uploaded to Facebook each month? Is it A, 2 billion photos and 14 million videos, B, 6 million photos and 20 billion videos, or C, 8 billion photos and 16 million videos? If you chose answer choice A, 2 billion photos and 14 million videos, you have answered correctly. Back to you guys in the studio.
Well, it's time for us to say goodbye now.
We hope you enjoyed this week's newscast. We'll be back with more news stories, PSAs, and Teen Talk. Until then, check out our Facebook page. Search FSM News.
You can also check us out on abc7chicago.com under the community section.
Thanks for watching FSM News. See you next time.
Free Spirit Media partners with schools and organizations to provide education, access, and opportunity in media production to underserved urban youth. Through hands-on production of their own media content, participants build life skills in communication, critical and independent thinking, teamwork, and the use of technology. Believing that youth perspectives are a critical element of American culture, Free Spirit Media actively distributes student work to a range of audiences. Participants' dreams and aspirations grow, and in turn, their voices and visions benefit our society.
Well, there you have it.
You see that? Treat your man with respect. Back to you in the studio. I shouldn't have pointed. Let's do it one more time.
Well, you know I'm volunteering at a homeless... Wait, I'm going to say help. Well, you know I'm volunteering at a help...
Help. Just say I'm volunteering.
Wait, I can't
get it.
Why the fuck you said help the shelter? You know I'm volunteering at a homeless shelter. So you want to come help me? What's
wrong?
Action. What the fuck is that? Oh.